All right, guys, so we're back here on the Buick today. If you haven't seen this thing, this is a 1970 Buick Skylark, and I bought this for my dad as a little project. Needs a rear end, got the rear end. I've been waiting on parts for about like 4 or 5 months now. A lot of stuff's been on back order for this thing. But this should be either the third or the second video, I'm not sure. But so needed a rear end, got a rear end. Needed some arms for the rear. We have the arms now. So today what I'm gonna do is try to pretty much get the rear end all buttoned up and get these arms buttoned up and get a rear end in this thing, get it to its a roller form basically, so I can get this thing over to his house and, you know, it'd just be at his house as a roller, because we are still waiting on body panel parts that are on back order. So yeah, what this thing's looking like. I'm not sure if I made another video, if I uploaded it yet, but if not, this is the second video. All right, so I'm out here getting this rear end put together. Just got the diff cover opened up, threw the axles in. Now I'm about to throw this pin in and all this other stuff. That should be good. I gotta go to AutoZone and get a tool to compress these bushings in, but that should be a little minor thing. Alright, so what I'm doing here is I'm getting this broken rear end torn apart just so I can get these drum brakes on the new rear end. Got the axle set in place and all that stuff, but yeah, just trying to take these take this last axle out of here so I can put this whole assembly on the new one. All right, so I got the brake drum off of the old one here. Now I am taking the drum off of the other side just so I can still get everything switched over.
Thank you for.
Okay, so got the new upper arms on. Now I just need to get the lowers in there. That one and that one. That one and that one. And then press these top bushings in. And then I should be good to get the rear end in. I'm not sure if this needs a new cylinder, if this is broken or not, or if it just needs the springs. Well, I'm sure it needs the springs up top, but this cylinder might be good, it might not be, so we'll see. Not really that too good with drum brakes, but yeah, I'm gonna get these lower arms on and then probably run to AutoZone and get some kind of tool to compress these bushings. Alright, so I took a little break and now we're back. Went to AutoZone and I picked up this little ball joint tool. And what I'm gonna do is pretty much just press these diff mounts in, and then we'll be pretty much ready to go to get this ring back in place. I gotta put that other arm back on, that's gonna take me like a minute. But I'm gonna press these mounts in real quick and then get going on this other arm. I'm hoping this goes the way I think it's gonna go, but I got the clamp on there. I don't think I should have anything here because I needed to push in, but we're gonna try to go for it, and can't really record this with one hand, but I'll let you guys know what the end result is. Okay, so what needs to happen is I need to get this in first and then press the poly mount in after. So I put this one in kind of wrong, so I just have to take it apart and then get the actual metal housing in first, and then I can hit these in with the mallet. Okay, so this is what I got set up here. I don't know how good this is gonna work, but still gonna go for it real quick. If it doesn't, then I might have to just get some kind of different kind of press, or take the rear end to get pressed by someone. just don't want to break the ears off, then I'll be fucked. But it seemed like it's kind of working a little bit, so I'll just keep going for it. Oh, there we go. So far I got one in. Wasn't easy, but it's getting there. Kind of marred up this a little bit, but it doesn't really matter. Bushing is going to go inside and cover that up. But got to put the clamp back on because it popped off. And get this one on and start working on that one. Sides, gotta adjust them and all that stuff. I got this arm on here, got the upper arms. So next up is just sliding this thing in, and I gotta get the drive shaft probably redone because this is pretty banged up from the accident. Yes, but this is pretty much probably my stopping point for tonight. Tomorrow I might come out here, put a couple hours on it. But yeah, I got the arms in, got the rear end kind of buttoned up. Still need to do the shocks inside. That I have to throw on shocks and springs. This arm, I couldn't get the bolt through yet, so I'm gonna do that tomorrow. That should take me little to no time. But yeah, this is probably my little stopping point for tonight. And yeah, this freaking car, panels are pretty hard to find for it. So if I don't find any soon, I'll just end up trying to pull this as best I can, just for now. I really want to cut it and redo it. But if parts are taking 3 to 4 months to come, I'll just do what I can for now. Just to get it looking decent.